Golf balls, they're expensive, right? You can spend best part of £50 on a dozen of them. So every one you lose, bye-bye, £3.50. So there are other options. I'm going to review today four new Titleist balls that are slightly cheaper than the Pro V1. I'm going to tell you who they're aimed at and should you buy them. My name is Sophie Walker. Welcome to our Golfalot channel and let's get involved. But before we get into this, please like, comment and subscribe to our channel. I want to know, what golf balls are you using? Is price a real reason why you buy them, or is it all about performance? Today's test is going to start with the Pro V1s. Look at these, fresh out of the packet. And I am going to hit 7 irons and drivers with these, because this is the balls that I use. I've always used them, but guess what? I'm a tour pro, I get them free. If I had to pay for them, would I go to a different ball? Who knows? So the four balls in question in price order are Tour Speed, Tour Soft, Velocity, and TruFeel. I've got the Pro V1s, got my 7 iron, flight scope. I'm here at Stockport Golf Club, and this is gonna be some full on testing. And wait till the end of the video, because there will be some short game also. I wanna test these entire golf balls through the bag. Next up, Tour Speed, they come in at £38, so about that £12 cheaper than the Pro V1 range. First impression, it looks different to a Pro V1. It's got an older fashioned stamping on it for me, that darker stamping, and it does have a different alignment aid. It says on the box that it's just looking for speed, distance, but it's going to give you control around the greens. This Tour Speed player's benefit, it reminds me of the irons that everybody seems to be going for in the amateur game now. It's that player's distance iron. Maybe these balls are supposed to match that. Can you get the best of both worlds? They're getting close in the irons. Can they do it in the golf balls? Let's see. Once again, starting with the 7 iron. Launch was higher, I felt, with the 7 iron. We'll obviously check that, but with the driver, it's a lot more busy and lower. I think these tour speeds are all right. Next up, Tour Soft, coming at £32. Now, this is a two-piece ball. We've said goodbye to the three-piece golf ball. And you can feel it. You can actually feel it on the cover. It's not as premium. You can tell. Once again, another alignment aid. So at the moment, it's like less on the Pro V1, a little bit more on the Tour Speed, and even more on this one. So this will line your putter face up square, and then the line for the start line. I think this is now, looking at this, this is where I notice that things have changed to the eye. I didn't notice as much on the Tour Speed, but right now things are looking different. Dimple patterns different, and what they're saying is that this is going to provide longer distance, a consistency in ball flight, and reliable short game control with still soft feel. So there's less of that spinning feeling to everything, I would say, because in a two-piece you're not going to get that. And this cover, I would say it's going to be durable. Titleist Tour Soft. Let's hit a few 7 irons. That one's different. That one felt more solid in the hit, harder than the last two. So did that one. I can feel it in my fingers a bit more. Now onto the Titleist Velocity. We have broken the 30 pound barrier. 28 pound for a dozen of these. And it still says Titleist on the box. I actually like the box. Reminds me a little bit of the Pro V. However, that's where it's gonna stop. See that? Got the little orange number on it. It may say Titleist on the ball, but doesn't look like one for me. That's because I've never used them. I've been very privileged. I keep saying this, that I have used the Pro V1. But, you know, alignment aid, nice. Quite like that alignment aid. And this is where things start to change on the box. Get every yard, longer distance, extremely low long game spin, high flights on all shots, and only playable around the green. Okay, when you're not paying as much for a golf ball, you're not gonna have it all. So I'm expecting low spin, high launch. Let's have a go with these Titleist Velocities. Easy for you to say, not for me. Not the ball over, for a bit of grass and shelly, it sounds. 7 irons to start with, Titleist Velocity. Oh, certainly a higher launch. Starting to, these last two lots of golf balls I've tried, the feel's not quite as there, but this one certainly feels higher. Further. What I would say about this testing, I can see the difference in the golf balls, only in the flight and the feel. I've not even checked the numbers yet. We'll see if they match up, but at least different balls are doing different things. Titleist TruFeel, last but not least, it's £2 a golf ball. Nearly half the price of Pro V1s. Yeah, alignment aid. Once again, different alignment aid. So that's quite nice that Titleist are offering so many different variations. We've now got the red number. That's kind of what I remember a Titleist to be, having red numbers. Cover, yeah, doesn't look to have as many dimples on it. However, it says that this new Titleist TruFeel is the softest Titleist golf ball designed with a larger, faster core for distance. So basically the cover is going to feel a bit soft, but what's inside is going to give you the injection to hit the ball further. So ultra soft feel and long distance. And then they start, like, they don't put spin around. They never put spin on these boxes when you get to this level. It's just excellent green control. The test of knocking it over, not as clicky as the last two. So maybe that cover, that true flex cover, is as soft as they say. I thought everything could get firmer and harder and clickier as we got cheaper and cheaper. These haven't, these have gone to a soft approach. Let's delve quickly into these numbers. Now, first of all, the good news is the balls did what they say they would. So looking at 7 irons, the Pro VX, the Tour Speed, the Tour Soft, all went a similar distance. But the distance jumped when we went to Velocity and TruFeel by about half a club. Why was this? Well, in the Velocity, it did launch higher and it did spin less. So spin rates, I'd lost a good 1,000 RPM from my Pro VX. In terms of launch, they all were, for launch heights, the height things were all going up ever so slightly from the Pro V1X to the Velocity. And then it did drop slightly in the TruFeel. That was a difference for me when I moved from the Velocity to the TruFeel. I did mention, didn't I, that I thought I would just keep going and going and going. That wasn't the case. So that's a slightly different ball, even though it's cheaper than what I expected. On to the drivers. Much of a muchness in terms of carry. Spin rates increased from Pro V1X all the way through. So maybe slightly surprised at that one because it was the opposite in the irons. But they're not surprised because that's what they keep saying the ball's doing. If you're looking at height, my height was much of a muchness for the Pro V1X, tour speed, tour soft. Then velocity certainly jumped up. I got another 10 feet on average. So they were saying how they wanted that high launch, low spin. I was getting the high launch, didn't quite get the low spin with it. I didn't see a great difference between the drivers. I saw a real big difference in the irons. And I've never had an amateur golfer come to me who are going to be using these balls and say, I hit it too far or I hit it too high. So in the irons, it's really going to help when that ball is on the ground. When it was off a tee, as I say, didn't notice a whole lot of difference other than a slightly different spin and a difference in height. Now, I'm going to go to the short game because that's where we hit most of our shots from. Right now, it's doing what it says on the box, but it's all about feel. And can we use it on the short game? I've just picked up my golf balls on the driving range. Note, velocity did run out more, so that was the longest. Now I'm moving on to chipping green. I've just got the four golf balls. I've left the Pro V1X out. I'm gonna do a few scenarios, give you a bit of feedback during the odd shot or two, and then I'll talk you through how I feel about all four of the golf balls and which one I think will suit you. And if price is really the main difference in all these golf balls. 25 yard pitch to a front flag. I've got the lob wedge out off a nice light. That clicked. That was the velocity. Oh, that was a lot softer. It ran out, but that about 3 or 4 yards short of where I thought I was gonna land it. So once again, standing out, the velocity, the TruFeel compared to the other two. The other two, through all this testing, I've not noticed a massive difference. Now on to a 50 yard pitch shot. Nice connections there. Both had a similar reaction. Oh, wow. Did you hear that? And it flew higher, actually. Yeah, so louder, felt quicker, flew higher, released more. That's the same as what I found in my long game. And then with that TruFeel, the spin increases, the softness increases, and it's reacting the same. Well, that's good. That's a consistency through the bag so far. It's quite nice that. That's three shots. I think I've played them the same. And you can see how they've released a bit further every time. That's proving a point. Yeah, and that one's finished by the velocity. I think that's a really good example there of everything that I've seen throughout this video, just in one shot, doing exactly what they say on the box. Well on Titleist. I like him. I like him a lot. When testing these golf balls, I expected them to get harder as I moved down the box, where actually it didn't. TruFeel, exactly what it said. It had a softer feel to it. TruFeel for me is somebody that needs some spin and wants that feel around the greens. Even if you don't want to spend a lot of money on a golf ball, it's still going to give you more feel than the velocity. The velocity is somebody that needs to hit it higher and further. They're playing golf courses that are too long for them, and they just need to get closer to the green with their third, fourth shots. That's where the velocity comes into it. You do notice a difference in feel even between those two. Moving up to tour soft, tour speed. These are really good golf balls. Really are. Now, I would say that you've always got to look at the Pro V1 will fit most golfers. The X does fit a different style of golfer, and that's obviously why I play it. But looking at these two, there was more spin in the tour soft. You'd expect that it says soft on the box rather than tour speed up there. But if you're a Pro V1 player, and you might be single figures, and you're thinking, 50 odd quid every dozen. For 12 quid cheaper, you're not losing a lot here. And maybe sometimes we do play the ball that we think we should play. You aren't going to lose too much in these, and you're going to get an extra 3 golf balls for your money. I was impressed with these. I like them a lot. Didn't see a whole lot of difference between the Pro V1X in the performance side of things, in the feel side of things. There is difference, but there should be difference. There should be a difference between the X and the Pro V1 and all of these. And there is. So Titleist do offer a ball fitting service. I would recommend that, you know. Don't just go in there, what's your most expensive, please? Yeah, I'll get Pro V1s or I'll get Pro V1X. Have a look around, because you could actually be saving yourself some money and getting the ball that suits you best. I hope this review has helped you think about golf balls, not just about price or just get the Pro V1X. It certainly opened my eyes to what is on offer. I was under the assumption that the less you pay for the golf ball, the harder, the firmer, the brick-like feeling. But it's not. The TruFeel certainly is not that. And just like with irons and drivers, where you go and get fitted and you find that style of club which suits your game, you can do it with golf balls. And I would recommend you having a look and trying a few of these and seeing which suits your game. You might save yourself a bit of money and get some more performance out of it. Thanks for watching that golf ball review. So many Titleist golf balls out there. Who knew? Anyway, I've been Sophie Walker. This has been Stockport Golf Club. We've had a great time reviewing these balls and explaining to you what suits your game. And that's the most important thing. That's what we want to do at Golfalot. If you want to read the written review, check it out on golfalot.com. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you again soon.